1992, the Charville Junior School Journey.
We're in the hall, waiting for the coach.
Our mum's dad's waiting outside to see us off.
This is no holiday and some people are already working.
And some people aren't.
I'm thirsty, but I've got the answer.
The museum was once a real mine and we were shown around by real miners. Unfortunately, our cameraman couldn't come in with us just in case he caused an explosion.
The journey was quiet and relaxing, but very long. We asked the driver to speed things up a bit, and he turned on turbo boost.
Hold on to your hats, here we go.
Whoosh! It's a horse!
Good time singing.
The coach was really rocking and rolling.
Last year when I arrived, they had to go to the classroom first.
But for us, we went into a big feast.
Thank you. a great meal. And now we're off for a walk around Tenby.
What do you think will happen if I jump down there, Mr. Hales?
This family's learning about rock pools.
And we're learning some Welsh.
Out.
And the dry dock is very dry.
Thank you.
Naughty boy.
No, not me.
And girls.
Any of our Francis and Timmy rock?
Well, look at me, Jackson.
Well, man, honestly, I
look at me.
I love when he casts. I laugh at his rod belly.
John!
Look what Stephen found!
Wait! No, look at me shaving. Come on!
Andy, shall I take it?
Yes.
Started unpacking, then the fire alarm went off, and then we went outside in bare feet, and then we came back in to the dinner hall, and then we ripped what we wanted for breakfast and lunch.
Right, and after we went out for our lunch, we had, well, some of us had cocoa, or some of us had orange juice, or some of us who didn't want that, had the water.
By the way, it was Anna's birthday yesterday, and we shared her birthday cake. And then we went upstairs, finished unpacking, and then we went to bed.
Good night.
Good night.
And we also told a couple of jokes.
Michelle came in and gave us a good night smacker.
And then we didn't go to bed till 21 past 12.
Hello, it is Wednesday today. We are going horse riding. Habra Kadabra.
Here we are at the riding school.
Tell me the thing. Are you looking forward to riding the horse?
Yes.
Howdy, cowboy.
To the beach later.
This
some fun, man.
That's fantastic.
Friday, by the way. He's very good.
His name's Quickstep.
Ready, say something.
It's very hard to control.
Everybody else's horses have wind except for ours.
Just give me a right, give me a left rather.
And take...
I'm wearing my horse allergy outfit.
I'm allergic to let Annie Spencer some I can do.
What do you think of it?
Brilliant. I'd rather come here and go to school any day.
Please, everybody, as you go past.
It's nice.
Shout out what you think of this as you go past.
Brilliant.
Winter.
Canoeing.
Excuse me, can you tell me what you think of this horse riding, please?
I think this is brilliant, man. It's a really good horse and it's excellent.
Fantastic.
This is wicked.
We're having a great time and I love this horse. This is Bryn. His name's Mowbray. And it really hurts my bum when I'm trotting.
The horsey rap.
We are on the beach now and we're going to do a scavenger hunt.
Tell us what it is first.
A scavenger hunt is where we have to find lots of different stones and shells and things.
Well, we found the shells, we're going to decorate them with our sandcastle.
Look what I've found.
It's already said, Ken. Martin's can.
Right, I'm going.
Hang on, don't go.
I'm shocked.
Me and Josh made it yesterday.
A piece of wood.
And we made a square. And then we did. Like, we pull up his square.
That's
good.
And they are done as well.
Great, these things are made. Great brain. Got to the edge. Just got to the pillar.
Swap jobs.
We're going to build the best castle!
We found a Welsh bottle with a Welsh dragon on it.
We felt like tramps because we had to find rubbish and we were searching through the bins.
I wonder where the others are.
Mr. House, there's three things we can't find, and they are cuttlefish bone, mermaid's purse, an empty Commonwealth egg case.
Well, I suggest you just go and look for them and do it now and get a move on.
I got a bivalve and I'm going to go and find some more.
Mrs. Shaler managed to find two off-duty police officers to be our judges.
Here's Mandy, one of our judges of our contest of the sandcastles, to work in groups.
I found something unusual.
What is it?
No.
Well, who is it?
Hello, Phil.
Hello, Phil.
Yeah, who is he?
He's another one of our judges.
Hello there. Well, I hope you're enjoying the beach expedition and the scavenger hunt. Now, come and look at this, please, because this here, this might just look like rubbish to you, but in actual fact, we've got some wonderful things here. There's a bit of a seaman's beard, and that's going to go on somebody's castle, I expect. Yes, and what's this? This is a seaman's biscuit, obviously off an old wrecked boat, and it's a lovely piece of biscuit there. And, of course, a leftover bit of the seaman's lunch. I think that was probably a chicken bone or something like that. And his razor blade. This is a seaman's razor blade. And these are what we find on the beach. It's very, very interesting.
This is what we call nowadays a crab claw.
We found it on the seashore over there. Our leader hasn't helped us at all because he's been busy going around filming everybody.
But what a super castle, look at it.
They came around boasting.
Great, go on.
It's basically come from the
back. Don't have playtime, so go on.
This is Josh and his video camera himself. I've had an asthma attack, I've just come back from the doctor's and I just had a nice see my girlfriend.
Josh, come on.
Rubbish.
Well, what do you think of it so far? I think we've had a look around some of the castles. It's quite a good presentation, and overall there's been good group involvement. But we need a few minutes just to make a little noise. We're just going to go around again now, just to make sure.
Tell us about your castle, come on.
Ah, well, this castle is ours. And we have to make it out of sand and objects on the shore.
Oh, I know where to put this.
The shore.
Our castle has got shells around it. We use cups for the thing shapes. And there's two bits to it.
And it's the shape of a number 8.
Yeah,
Very gently.
Let's go in there.
Not on the mound.
No, we don't need it.
I'll get some more.
Right, I don't want that much.
Oh, yeah.
I still want quite a lot.
Yeah, we got a Welsh.
What's your name?
Our sandcastles made of sand, shells, seaweed.
What are we going to use the rope for?
Yeah, I'll
hide it.
Wet stones.
What are we going to use the rope for?
Pebbles.
Great.
What else do we need to
pass? What's the name of the castle?
Do you have a name? Claws. Got another one of these. Over there somewhere. It's over there.
Where are we going to put it then?
I know! Put it on top of the...
Right, put it in somewhere then, let's have a look what you've got.
I was going to put
got
a
your
tree.
Feather.
I haven't finished yet.
I'm going to nip my leg.
Piece of rope, or string. Yeah. Piece of wood.
We did have that big little bit of wood.
Oh, we did.
So making it a
down, down, deeper and down.
Look what I found.
What is it? Oh, look who they belong to.
This is silly.
Waggle them, please. Any other ones?
David, don't do it. Don't do it. Please don't go.
Don't go to Australia. Come back.
Charville really left its mark on the beach. Now it's back to the hotel.
This is a classroom behind me. Who has ever heard of a classroom on holiday? If you come with me, I'll show you what they've been doing. Yeah. We came out here about half an hour ago. We've been doing our diaries. And we've been writing a poem about horse riding where we went today. And when we finished that, we have to do some jobs for Miss Shayla or do something else for Miss Shayla. And then we have to do something else about our diary.
Ian will now read you his poem.
Come on, Ian. There's your book. It's a good one. Go on. Read it.
Go on, read it. Hold your book. Read it.
Don't
Why not? Right, hold it.
Yeah.
There's your book. Right, read your page. Read it. Yes. Right, there it is. It's in that book. He's going to read it for us. Right, off you go, Ian. I'm ready.
But Ian Kennedy would not read his poem.
Get a load of this then!
Anna was the only one who had a birthday.
To you, happy birthday, dear Alan. Happy birthday to you.
Somebody who's big and tough and strong. Cocoa and slipper shirt, it was time for bed.
Good night, Mummy. Good night, Daddy.
Good night, Mum. Good night, Dad.
Good night.
night, Mummy and Daddy. I'm not missing Garen, so good night.
I thought you were asleep. Now get to sleep.
Has anybody got stuck a minute, Andrew?
Oh, that was murder.
Watch it, watch it! Nick!
They are knocking each other over.
Oh, stop, stop, stop.
Funny. How far down do we go?
To the water's edge.
I wonder where Chris is. Let's have a look for him.
Touch more. Just down here.
Okay, fine. Just keep on the road.
Good.
Lean back slightly more, so you've got heels on the rock. Nice looking down onto the rock place, it's great. I think your feet are further apart now, just step down. That's good. Lean back hard, pull your weight on the rope. Just keep walking backwards. You've done all the time now. Try not to get too tight on the sand. Right now, it'll work. Just relax. Excellent. We'll see how the time goes.
It was great.
There was a real atmosphere of friendship and teamwork.
We are now going into the sea.
Do you like getting wet, Josh? Push us away.
Are you having fun down there?
Yeah, we're all going to the sea now.
Josh,
don't pull in! Carly!
The other way!
All paddle as hard as you can!
No, no, you're not allowed!
See where
wait
we go!
Wait for Max!
Yeah, that's why I'm
putting
it. It keeps blocking
the
boat!
That's right.
I'm singing
higher.
Did our boat
stay
out back on it?
Your
boat's got out back on it.
We're going to double that sea ring anyway.
Jim.
We must paddle on the jumping seas.
Everyone paddle right! Let me paddle right!
Oh,
hi,
Beck! How are you?
Follow
that!
Follow that!
Get out of the next
street! You two paddle on the right, that's
great.
Next, it was Alan's turn. He fought long and hard before going down. To save time, we cut the film a few places. We can't imagine what he was scared of. At last, he was going down. Then it was Kelly's turn.
Kelly, smile. There's
a box coming back.
This is really scary. This is skillful. Watch the box.
Look at a skeleton, you're smashing the box.
All right, let's do another one.
About to strike. Watch the girl in the middle. She
shoes lift up the creek without a paddle. Their last chance of survival slipped through their fingers.
Here comes the hero to save the day! But can he get the paddle?
What a hero! He's finally done it again! It's Max from Germany!
Bom bom.
Holland.
Oh. Hello again. Oh, he's from Holland, my mistake.
Meanwhile, on the rocks, they're packing up.
So what were they like?
Not bad. They all did it. A couple of them didn't go all the way down. But they still had a good go. Didn't get time for a second go, unfortunately.
All pretty brave, were they?
Yeah, pretty good. Not too many tears.
Down in the valley, people are starting to get wet.
Like Scott.
Scott.
Quite a few of us fell in the water, but not on purpose.
Yeah, David, pull the other one.
James Bond.
No, Premium Bond.
Tony.
Yeah! It's 20 for us.
We got one, haven't we?
Oh, did you see him this morning on that cliff?
What about those troops? I was already cheering this morning and I got totally lost.
That's right, that's fine. You got some shoes?
Yeah, go again.
Hey boys, we're gonna hit the road. It's on our way. In it.
One, two, three, four, five. Who's missing?
Kelly and Jimmer.
Where are they?
Richard.
You're gonna be missing one.
This is a rough ride.
This is gonna be a rough ride. So turn it off now.
Now.
Go on.
The reason I called you fat is because you called me lanky. I called you fat and then you called me lanky. But you called me lanky and I called you fat.
Mr. Hales, it's not on, is it?
Yeah.
That's
you got
bear.
Jaws has been eating at you. La la la. Mm.
It's called the Ram's Nose. Get there, we're gonna wade into the water.
get wet, it's nice and warm. Oh, some little sea now and again. It's a really good laugh. We had an absolute hoot this morning.
Okay.
We've got to wear some of these fantastic garments over here.
I'm not sure.
Because what happens if you fall over on the rocks, you damage your wetsuit. You can see they've already ticked. Time.
Ow.
Ow.
I've got a bruise on my finger. A bruise. Ow. That's excellent, isn't it? On your hand.
What?
That's the same for me. Because Bishop's Rock and Ramsey. About.
Yes.
About
300
miles.
No. 5 miles. Three. That one there's 4 miles offshore. But sometimes we canoe out to it. It takes about 2 hours to canoe out to it. You can sleep on it. It's a really good island. Right. Yeah. Anyway, there's a piece of trivia for you.
You
Here's James Bond again.
Sure-footed as ever. Richard Butler's done it again!
It was a long, tiring day.
We were glad to get to bed.
Yes. Good night, Mum. Good night, Mum.
Good night, good night. It was a bad night. It never finished.
Oh, by the way, good night, Mummy and Daddy and Natalie. See you later.
Simon's girlfriend. Simon's girlfriend.
That's
yeah.
Mine.
And that's my one. See, it's called Jean.
Okay, and I've got
down
Fred.
It's amazing. You never
sussed
out.
Is he good, Mrs. Shayla?
Yeah, I don't know, did it? That is mine. And he did write his down before mine. Right, Jonathan.
Bye.
Is that Anthony?
Right.
Daddy.
Get on with it.
Good night,
Mum and Dad. Good night. Not Mum, not Dad. Not Jamie, generally. Not Charlie. Not Fish, we're behaving.
Is that everyone now? You sure?
Yeah.
Good night, Mum, Dad, Jamie, Dylan.
I was asleep! Oh well, I better say something. Good night, Mum, Gazza, my brother.
Good night, Mommy and Daddy. Night, Mummy. Night, Mummy. Night, Daddy.
Mummy and Daddy.
Not Mummy and Daddy.
Oh no.
Yuck.
No, no, Mummy. No, no, Daddy. Bye.
You're still filming, Chris.
You are.
Oh, no.
Red lights on.
Oh, dear. Right. Be a bit.
No, Mummy. No, no, Daddy. And so
must I. He's not.
Oh. Go.
Good
night. Say good night to Mummy and Daddy.
Good night, Mummy and Daddy.
Goodbye. You can play kiss to Mummy.
Good night.
Might be toe.
Then go.
Look what I can do.
And I can do.
We arrived here at 10:40 and we're just splitting into two groups to walk around to have a look. In the afternoon we'll be going to the Tudor Merchant's House. After that we'll have a look around Tenby and some shops.
Right.
Going round there, and there's a party to come after us, and if we're all going in the same direction, we help, well, we'll get into a heck of a mess, won't we? Right? And in the end, I'll probably end up with quite a...
Father?
Hello.
He's not. He is creepy. Hello. Hi.
Who's house?
They were the sixth. They had the same Welshman called Owen Tudor. The Tudor was made Earl of Pembroke 18. Oh, she was beautiful. She was called Margaret Beaufort. Margaret Beaufort. And because she was a Beaufort, she was connected to the throne of England to be crowned on the battlefield. Because... Any other questions? Papagas to do with all my talking. Years old next. Year. Select it to Pembroke. And then come to the first council year. Now we know the capital of the castle.
Where that road was, a ditch about 8 meters long under the shop, and there would have been a little bridge. You know, the Normans were like that. With actual back there, what do you do? Let's have a look at this. This. Do you know what a portcullis looks like? It's on the back of a pet toy. There we are, there's a port, an actual fact. Pierced by a Welsh arrow. And the arrow went right through his thigh.
Armies would have been wiped out on the continent.
Be carrying the battering ram. Let's see your arms run the battering ram. What would these be doing? You'd have a shield up there, over your heads, and over their heads as well. So you may even have two shields. Why? Because up there, there are men down there. Let's see how we're going to charge up the gates. But I want real three hatchouts. Charge! Well, that could have frightened me.
That was embarrassing.
Not yet. It's condensed boiling oil. Probably boiling lead. And boiling water. Do you know why they prefer to use boiling lead than boiling oil? No, because they can pick the lead up and use it again. Whereas you pack with oil.
Reusable.
So it's called the murder hole. And remember, someone was said you're going to try and burn these down. If you're burning them down, you're going to be killed. Quite a few. Yes, but from the murder hole here, they can pour water down and put the fires out. And they can fire on you from there. And here are 10 centimeter thick oak doors. Let's go into the settlement. We're actually standing in the basement of this keep. What do you think they'd store here in the pool? Well, they'd store their food and their water. Yes?
After the tour of the castle, we bought some souvenirs and done some drawings.
We've got leaflets. How much are they? Two leaflets. No. Spray them. Yeah.
Pembroke Castle is great. We just came back to Tenby to have our lunch. Yum yum.
This is it.
Hey.
Thank you.
What's that?
Yes, pal.
Oh, sorry.
Tell him. Somebody has to what?
Film you again.
Oh.
Now we're on our way to the children's merchant's house. I think it's that way.
Who's leading?
But we're not sure, are we, Tanya?
No.
So I can't remember. Lovely, isn't it?
The Tudor Merchant's House is owned by the National Trust.
No photographer, leave that all right.
They weren't very nice, they wouldn't let us take any pictures or photos.
But here's a quick glimpse through the front door. After that, Josh the cameraman nipped off for a bit of peace and quiet.
Tudor Merchant House was very interesting.
We have to say that.
When we came out, we went shopping around Tenby for souvenirs.
We walked back to the hotel, had a dip in the swimming pool, and then it was talent night.
And I've got my joker at the ready.
Thank you.
trick tone.
It disappeared again.
Wow.
How'd
you do it?
Top.
Easy. Whee.
I thought you might
put that corn there. Alright. Right, that's my next trick. I want you to
These girls were singing, "We're walking in the air," but Josh let them down badly.
But he couldn't find the music to play for them.
Well done.
Oh, I know that one.
You just got like that.
Shush.
Still works.
They're off to find a hunk from the audience.
Is that Fred Darth Vader?
What?
Is that Fred Darth Vader?
Yeah.
Oh, right. Bye, Darth Vader.
Bye. The talent night was fantastic. Now we're going over to Joe Cool in the hotel.
It's all happening right down below me. Under this floor, the kids are boogieing the night away to the sound of the beat. And it's cool, man. Really cool. We're going to find out where it's happening tonight. So let's groove you on down to the boogie in the basement. Follow me. Hey, cool.
Yeah.
true. Everything I do, oh, I do it for you.
After the disco, the teachers told us how to strip the beds in the morning. There's a lot to remember, but we speeded it up for you. It's the last morning and we're giving the teachers presents to say thank you. This is Mike and Sue Smith, the hotel owners.
They just love teapots.
Once again,
Mr. Smith gave us a special award for being such a good school.
The best school that we've had again this year. So I don't know where your shield is, but once again, I've got great pleasure in presenting to the children of Charville their shield for 1992 for their politeness, good behaviour and friendliness. And I'll give it to Mrs. Shaler to look after it for you.
Especially requested by Mr. Smith. Now here's Nadine, Kelly and Jade with an excellent poem.
We're in Tenby, we've been good and not so leery. Every night before we sleep in the teacher's creek to give us a good night kiss for our mums we won't miss. We've been on a coastal week, we were so tired we couldn't talk. The food has been really great. Everything on my plate I've ate. People have been really friendly. We've decided we love Tenby. Our journey home will soon be here and we will all shed a tear.
Hit the road.
We left thank you cards in the hotel dining room.
Hi.
You'll miss it, will you?
We've had a great holiday at Tenby and now we're off.
Just time for one more photograph.
Yeah.
It was a great week and I don't want to go.
At last he was on the coach and heading for home. It was a week we'll never forget.
Can we turn this
off?
Not so loud.
You turn it up, please.
Not so. This is tinkling.
Just a little bit.
Video.
The best bit of the holiday was St. David's Day. The worst bit was the coast walk.
My favourite bit was the canoe. The disco was rubbish.
My best bit was when we done the canoe. No, I didn't do the canoe, I went surfing and done abseiling down the wall. My worst bit was when I done horse riding.
I reckon the best bit when we went around the cliffs on the beach, the sea surfing instead, because and my worst bit was because I thought we was gonna get lost in the orienteering.
My best bit was buying my new hat.
My worst bit was going on the coastal walk, and my best bit was going canoeing and abseiling down the cliff.
The best bit was horse riding the adventure. I liked all of it, except the coast walk and this now going away.
I didn't have my best bit. All of the holiday was brilliant. And there was one thing I didn't like about it, because the dinners weren't as big as they are at home.
My best bit was when Miss Wilson fell off when she was climbing.
Louder.
The best bit was when Miss Wilson fell off the climbing thing. And
What was your worst bit?
What was your best bit?
The worst bit was when I did upside down the cliff.
My best bit was the hotel dinners. And my worst bit was canoeing.
The worst bit was school.
My best bit was all bit except for schoolroom and when I got told off. Well,
crossing the Severn Bridge. Safely back on English soil, we decided to stop for refreshments before continuing with our long and arduous journey to Charville Junior School.
Josh, trying to carry his lovely food. Yeah.
Severn Bridge, opened by Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, accompanied by His Royal Highness the Duke of Edinburgh, on the 8th
September 1966.
Nigel!
Yeah.
helped us travel. And over there is the Severn Bridge.
We're having our sandwiches.
And now we are having our sandwiches.
No, you was not. You were sitting
over here. Penny, Robert. Right, who hasn't got sandwiches?
Oh, Jonathan.
I've actually got it. Anna.
Simon.
Is it going?
Of course it is.
Oh, I can't tell. I can't see. My favourite bit of this holiday was all those wonderful goodnight kisses. And the worst bit of the holiday was being followed by this.
Have you got any crisps?
I'm not going to look. I'm just... Oh, I've got one anyway.
It's closed at the moment, so it's roughly.
Who else?
I ain't drinking.
Yep.
Tenby, our journey home was really dear, and we all shed a tear.